series. The Tyler series is nothing but you see in the calculus, suppose I'm having a general transcendental function, exponential function, trigonometry function, whatever the function it may be, I want to express that function in a polynomial function means, then the Taylor's function will come in handy. Okay, for example, I want to express a trigonometry function in an approximate polynomial function means, okay, then what you have to use? You have to use the Taylor series. This is very, 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 the Taylor series, name. The importance of Taylor series is huge in engineering application, guys, because people from mechanical department, if you study FEA, finite element method, there we are approximating our complicated functions, right? The approximation is done by Taylor series only. Okay, not only here, people from any department, you are using any computation simulation, in your computation simulation without Taylor series, you can't do anything. Okay, then this Taylor series is normal for real value function for, complex function. Yesterday I told you, the limit is changed from minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, so here the 0 to infinity is nothing but your analytical part. Okay, then this minus infinity to minus 1 to minus infinity is nothing but your principal part. The reason it is called as principal part is because it is going singular. The principle, because it is nothing but 1 by z minus n the whole power n. It is going singular. So the singularity part is nothing but your principal part. Okay. So yesterday I told you three singularities: removable singularity, isolated singularity, and essential singularity. Removable singularity means the function may look like singular, but when you take the series form, you won't get the singularity terms. That is removable singular. Okay. Then the second one is like essential singular. Essential singular means throughout the series, I'm having a singularity term means, then it is called the essential singularity. Okay. The third one is isolated singularity. Isolated singularity means if I'm having analytical domain, if I'm having singularity point here, then like the other singularity point will be in the neighborhood, it doesn't have any more singularity. The next singularity will be like somewhere far from the first singular. This is isolated. This is nothing but isolated singularity. Then I have defined the concept of pole and order. Pole means the point at which the singularity happens. Here the pole means A is the pole. Okay, because at that point singularity happens, then the order of the pole is nothing but the maximum order where the series is having is nothing but the order of the pole. Now that's all about the previous concepts. Now let us go on to the conformal mapping. What this conformal mapping means? Okay, in a real value function, if you attend my calculus course for a real value function f is equal to f of z, geometrically I have given you a lot of information, right? Geometrically, in a sense, for a function, this is my function. Okay, this the derivative is nothing but the slope of the function. That is one thing. Okay, then we use the derivative. The derivative is positive means the function is increasing. Derivative is negative means the function is decreasing. The double derivative means a concave function. Double derivative positive means it is a concave function. So those kind of things I have explained in the calculus, right? So you can able to geometrically you can visualize. Similarly, the integration of f of z, f of d is nothing but area under the curve. You can geometrically relate something geometric, but here in complex, I told you some Cauchy-Riemann and other things, but you can't able to relate geometrically, right? But this is where the part. This is where you can geometrically relate your complex function. You can geometrically visualize your complex function, what is happening, and everything can be visualized using conformal mapping. For example, let me have a, you got it right? Let me have a function, a real value function, f is equal to f of x. This is my real value function, guys. If you attend my calculus, you know that it contains a domain and it contains a range. Domain and range. Domain is a set of input values. This is where I can take my input values. Okay, domain is a set of input values. I can take my input values in this particular domain. Okay, and range is once I substituted the input values in the function, then I'll get the output values. Output values are nothing but the range. You got it right? Output values are nothing but the range. So, for example, let me have a function, mx plus c. It is a straight line function, right? Y is equal to mx plus c is a straight line function. The domain can be a three-dimensional domain. I can take x from any value. Any x can be taken from the domain. But the output will be like only a straight line. Output, the range will be a one-dimensional range. You got it, right? That is the beauty of the function. The function will play a role. ஓகே டொமைன் யூ கேன் டேக் எனி பஞ்ச் ஆஃப் வேல்யூஸ் இங்கிருந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 110, 100 ஐ கேன் டேக் எனி வேல்யூ ஃப்ரம் த எக்ஸ் டொமைன் பட் இந்த ரேஞ்ச் சப்ஸ்டியூட் தட் இட் வில் பி லைக் நோ பேஸ்ட் ஆன் யுவர் எக்ஸ் யூ வில் பி யுவர் ரேஞ்ச் வில் பி லைக் எ ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன் விச் மீன்ஸ் எ ஸ்லோப் த ரேஞ்ச் வில் ஆல்சோ பி எ லைக் திஸ் ஸோ யுவர் ரேஞ்ச் வில் பி எ பஞ்ச் ஆஃப் திங்ஸ் வென் யூ சப்ஸ்டியூட் யுவர் இன்புட் வேல்யூஸ் யூ காட் இட் ரைட் ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் வாட் range will be a straight line based on the slope and m and c now for this complex function this is for a real value function guys similarly for a complex function this is my input plane complex function is a plane guys because we are having a real x axis and imaginary y axis okay this is my z plane okay how this z plane I'm taking values from the domain my z plane is a domain guys okay here w is equal to f of z okay this is the complex function similarly to a real value function okay z is my domain means at where I'm taking the bunch of points or whatever it is domain okay w is my range if I take one point from the domain and substitute into the function the other point how it the same point in the range you got it right so range means the output value input I'm substituting one value in the function I'm getting an output value so this is nothing but conformal mapping of complex function you got it right this is nothing but simply take the value from the domain and substitute in the function you will get the output value right so this is nothing but conformal mapping the reason they are using is nothing what is specialty about conformal mapping it is same as every function does right here a function goes to x goes to y and it gives you the range what is the specialty why they are calling us conformal mapping the beauty of this thing is if an input the domain z domain okay z domain I am having two functions two curves curve 1 and curve 2 this is curve 1 and curve 2 you got it right so I'm taking bunch of domains right bunch of domain means I'm taking the points in the curve 1 similarly taking the points in curve 2 and substitute into the function w is equal to any f of z any complex function if you do that the output I'm getting I will get this curve will be transformed this curve will be transformed in any way okay curve will be transformed this is c1 star and c2 star the output range w domain okay W domain. The beauty of this conformal mapping is this angle is preserved. The angle between these two curves. For example, let me draw a tangent here and let me draw a tangent over there. Then we can measure the angle theta, right? The same, the output also. If I draw the tangent in the intersection point, tangent here and tangent there, this angle will be theta. This angle is preserved, guys. This is the beauty about this conformal mapping. Okay, the angle between two intersecting curves. You got it right. It will be preserved. So its application is huge. When we going to the bonus point, I'll teach you that. Okay, so application is huge. So this angle is preserved. This is nothing but conformal mapping. You got it right. So that's what I have drawn here. Suppose let me have my function f of z is equal to z square. Okay, then f of z is equal to z square means write into in UV form. Write this in UV form. Substitute z is equal to x plus iy then substitute x is equal to x plus iy we can say that x plus iy the whole square then this is nothing but the real part of the complex function and this is the imaginary part of the complex function you got it right so f of z is written as something like this now this is my u this is my v okay now let me take one point in the z plane one point in the z plane so the point is nothing but 1, 1 so this point is nothing but 1, 1 which is nothing but 1 plus I a complex function of 1 plus I substitute that u of 1, 1 x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1 your answer will be like 0 and v is nothing but 2 so in complex function this point is transformed to this point you got it right this point is transformed to this point so this is nothing but 0, 2 this 1 comma 1 is transferred to 0 comma 2. Similarly, you take any bunch of input points, like take a bunch of lot of input points. I'm taking lot of input points. The correspondingly, I'll be having a output points. You got it, right? Whatever it is, I'm drawing arbitrary guys. You have to define. Okay, this is nothing but